when you speak to a transplant operator, and you ask, have you ever heard about regenerative medicine? The answer probably is going to be yes. But the transplant operator would associate the idea of regenerative medicine and tissue engineering to the idea of building organs. And so if we consider that as a goal, as an ultimate goal, clearly we are not there yet. And current technology, unfortunately, is not able to produce, to engineer an organ, ideally coming from patients' own cells. And if you ask me when that may happen, clearly it's not going to be in 5 years. Probably several decades are still needed before we will be able to deliver to the bedside kidney, an artificial kidney, a liver, a heart, any of those organs that we implant on a daily basis. However, many technologies that are regenerative medicine inspired are already being tested in clinical trials or have come to fruition. For example, one of the fields that has boomed in the last 2-3 decades has been the field of beta cell replacement, which means the attempt of producing those cells that regulates the sugar metabolism, the glucose metabolism, which means type 1 or type 2 diabetes, using progenitor cells, so different forms of stem cells. And many companies are working, have been involved in the field. The leader clearly has been Biocyte, that has been on clinical trial now for several years. And that's probably the most striking example. But also another example comes from organ preservation, which means when you do a transplant, in most cases it's from a deceased donor. So what happens is that the organ is procured, but in most cases, several hours pass by before the organ is implanted in the patient. So the organ needs to be stored somehow. And traditionally, it has been stored in ice. But in the last couple of decades, actually, normothermia, which means placing the organ not in ice anymore, but in a circuit where it's kept more or less at bodily temperature and in the system that the organ is continuously perfused with the state of the art solution. That's a form to me of organ repair and regeneration. At the same time, in the last decade, a groundbreaking concept that's been implemented, which is the idea of the organ repair center. The organ repair center, that's not science fiction, but actually it's something that it's already happening in North America in the setting of lung transplantation. These are highly specialized centers that basically drain all the marginal lungs that are recovered. And what happens at that center, the organ is received, is placed in this system, and is subjected to a series of tests, but also to a series of treatments that aims to regenerate and repair the organ. In other words, that aims and render the organ that 10 years ago would have been discarded transplantable. And several technologies are being developed. One of these is, for example, the use of stem cells, progenitor cells, like the type of cells that is very much being considered is mesenchymal stem cells that are extremely popular in tissue engineering, or also mitochondria are being used in order to, again, render the organ transplantable. So there's a lot going on in the field showing that regenerative medicine is already impacting transplant medicine. So it's a very exciting time, I would say.